Hello everyone. Now we are going to study about the financial functions in Excel program. Today we are going to take the financial function future value. It is denoted by FV. I'm Dr. C. Sudhakar with you, and you are watching your favorite math learning channel, We Learn Math. FV is useful to calculate the future value of an investment based on a fixed interest rate compounded periodically. The investment can be made either periodically over a period or as a single lump sum payment. Now let us see what is the syntax of this FV. The syntax for FV having these five components. First one is the rate. Rate means the rate of interest which is offered constant throughout the period. NPER, the total number of payments paid in an annuity. That means NPER. Now the third factor is PMT. It is simply the PMT, the payment made each period. PV, this is optional if the payments are made periodically. If the payment is made lump sum, we have to specify what is the worth of present value of the investment. Now type. Type is having two options, 0 and 1. Usually it will be left as blank. 0 means we have no outstanding payments. 1 means there is one payment due. Now let us take a sample problem and we will check how to calculate it. Now let us take an example and we will see how to use it in the Excel function to get the output or future value of an investment. Find the future value for a lump sum payment of 2000 riyals after 7 years at 6% interest compounded annually. Now let us see what is the syntax for it. This is the syntax: FV, rate, NPER, payment, present value, type. From this question, the rate is 6%. It is given in the question. We have to watch that whether the compound interest is given annually or quarterly or monthly or biannually. Now in this question it is given annually, so just put 6%. NPER, that means total number of payments in an annuity. Here it is paid for 7 years, so NPER is 7. PMT, how much money we are paying periodically. Here this is a lump sum payment, therefore periodic payments will not be there, but the lump sum payment paid initially is 2000 riyals. So PMT will be 0. We are not paying regularly, but a lump sum of 2000 is paid at the beginning, so PMT will be 2000. One more thing we have to note down: whenever we are paying money into the account, so we have to enter it negative value, negative of that number. If you are taking the money from the account, if you are getting the payments from the account, it should be positive. Now since we are paying the money, it should be entered as minus 2000. There is no outstanding payment, so we can make 0, or simply we can leave it as a blank one. Now let us go to the Excel sheet and we will see how the rule is working. Rate is 6%. Now we have to specify what is the number of payments. Number of payments here is 7 years. compounded annually. That means totally we are going to make 7 payments only. Next is payment. We are not going to make any periodic payments, so it is 0. The next one is, what is a lump sum payment? That is a present value. Present value is initially we are paying to the account, so we have to enter it minus 2000. Whatever the value given here, make it as minus 2000 here. Now, how much is the outstanding for that? What is the type here? Type is simply left blank. Now, we will input the rule here. The total maturity amount or the future value is given here. It is equal to FV. So this is the rule. First one is the rate. Here is the rate, comma, total number of payments 7, comma, how much we are paying periodically, it is 0, comma, what is the present value? The present value is minus 2000, comma, nothing is in the type, so simply we can close it. Enter. Usually it will give in terms of dollars. In case if you want to change it into reals, now select the cell, format cells. Here you will have all the currencies. Omani reals is having 3 decimal places, that is 100 paisa equal to 1 real. So make 3 decimal places and you can choose the symbol OMR here. Click OK. So it will give price in terms of Omani reals. Now let us take another example. We will take the same example with a slight modification. Find the future value for a lump sum payment of 2000 reals after 7 years at 6% interest compounded annually. Now we make a small change here. Compounded offerly. Now the data is same. Future value, rate, total number of payments, payment, present value and type. The rate is 6%, now divided by 2. If it is off early, it is given, take the 6%, it is off early, so 6% divided by 2. Okay, per year we are having 2 offs, so divide it by 2. The number of years is 7, so total number of payments will be, for 1 year we are making 2 payments, for 7 years 7 multiply 2 you will make 14 payments. It is a lump sum payment, so monthly payment will be 0 or offerly payment will be 0. Now 2000 reals is the payment we are giving from our pocket, so it is enter its minus 2000. The last factor type you can leave it as blank. Now let us make the changes here. It is compounded off early. It is compounded off yearly. Or it is same that biannually. So other data are same. Interest rate you have to divide it by 2. And how many payments we are making? We are making 7 payments. So 7 multiply 2, 14 payments. Monthly payments is 0. Initially we are making a payment of minus 2000. So therefore this is 3025.179. is the money we will get it after 7 years. In case if you are paying this in the beginning and the interest rate is compounded quarterly, now the changes are, interest rate, we have to divide it by 4. So per year we are making 4 payments for 7 years. 7 multiply 4, we will make 28 payments. Initial payment is -2000 and periodic payments is 0. The type is left blank. So at the end of a 4th year, we will get 3034.444. Now, if it is monthly, the changes are accordingly. Now, the changes is, it is interest rate is divided by 12 months. So we are going to make 12 payments in a year. 7 into 12, 84 payments in 7 years we are going to make it. Monthly payment is 0. Initially we have invested 2000 riyals. So we have invested -2000. So final output will be 3040.739 Now let us take this example. Find the maturity amount for a monthly payment of riyals 350 for 7 years at 6% interest compounded monthly. The difference between the last question and this is, payments are made on monthly basis, not as a lump sum payment. So the data will be changing a little bit. This is the rule or the formula: FV, rate, NPER, payment, present value and type. The rate is 6%. We are paying monthly, so 6% divided 12. Now NPER, that is the total number of payments, will be 7 years into 12. That is the total number of payments for the period. Now again, there is a payment we are going to make it, so it should be negative. So payment is monthly payments, that is a periodic payments, is 350 riyals. So now PMT will be -350. Present value of the account is, we are not having any money in the account, so it is 0. Present value is 0. Type is left blank. Now let us go to the Excel and we'll see what is the output for this. Now this is our question. Find the maturity amount for a monthly payment. So the rate of interest is 6% equal to 6% divide 12. Total number of payments will be 7 years. So it is equal to 7 multiply 12. Payment. Now we are making a payment of 350 riyals per month. So we are making, so it is -350 in payment. Now present value is 0. Present value is 0. We are not having any money in the account at the beginning. Now the type is 0, or we can leave it blank. Now we can input the rule here. It is equal to FV, open the bracket, this is the rate, comma, total number of payments, payment periodically, present value, and type we can select or we can leave it blank. Both means is same. So 36,425.875 mani riyals will be the maturity amount. At the end of 7 years, we will get this amount if 6% interest compounded monthly. Enjoyed learning mathematics with me? Please subscribe to this channel and click the notification symbol for quick updates. Wish you all the best. Signing off, Dr. C. Sudhakar. And this is your favorite math learning channel, We Learn Math.